So now the ciliary ganglion, which is the parasympathetic ganglion placed in the passage of or in the course of oculomotor nerve, lies in the between the optic nerve and the lateral rectus muscle. It receives parasympathetic through the oculomotor, sensory through nasociliary nerve, and sympathetic through the internal carotid plexus. So the parasympathetic route, it passes through the nerve to inferior oblique muscle. This is inferior oblique muscle. From the nerve to inferior oblique muscle, the parasympathetic route it passes it upward. These are the preganglionic in the ciliary ganglion. So preganglionic fibers and the postganglionic fiber through the short ciliary nerve. It passes and innervates the constrictor pupil and the ciliary muscle, which are the intrinsic muscle of the eye. Another one is the sympathetic one. It is through the internal carotid plexus or the artery. So internal carotid plexus contains the postganglionic, these are the postganglionic fiber to the ciliary ganglion. And these fibers they arise from the superior cervical ganglion. And the preganglionic fiber, they reached through the T1 segment. The postganglionic fiber from the internal carotid plexus reached to the ciliary ganglion. Now the third one is sensory through the nasociliary nerve, which is the branch of ophthalmic nerve. The communicating branches from the nasociliary nerve passes to the ciliary ganglion. So this ciliary ganglion receives parasympathetic through the oculomotor, sensory through the nasociliary branch of the ophthalmic one, and the sympathetic through the internal carotid plexus, the postganglionic fibers. Then it innervates the constrictor pupils or the ciliary muscle, which are the intrinsic muscle of eye. It lies medial to the eyes, in between the optic nerve and the lateral rectus muscle. So this is all about the ciliary ganglion as well as the oculomotor nerve.